No, we'll make out.
Okay.
Who are you?
I'm Claudette. I'm Claudette. I'm with DJ Mary TV. Thank you, sister. Thank you. So let's get back to business.
Let's get back. She's more, okay.
So you're one of the performers.
Yeah, I'm with the comedian, Davey and Valette.
So tell us about you. What do you have coming up?
I got a TV show coming out, me and Talent, called Black Tino Comedy Jam, which is like a combination of Def Jam and Soul Train. What we do is we have a comedy show first, live musical guests, after party after, but every episode is filmed at different nightclubs. No, it's in English. Talent don't speak Spanish, neither do I. So. I went to summer school for Spanish, it's embarrassing. You'll hear about it in my act tonight. But our next Black Tino show is at Don Coqui in White Plains this Thursday. And it's free to get in, bring as many people as you want. CDs at 7, shows at 8.
All right, give us the address.
Mamaroneck Avenue, Don Coqui in White Plains. I know it's over there.
And what's the time again?
CDs at 7, shows at 8 o'clock.
Okay, if people wanted to reach us, so you can
look me, on Instagram, Comedian Davian Velez. That's DAVIANVELEZ. Or Facebook, Davian Velez.
Well, you guys heard it. Davian Velez, come out and support a brother.
I'm going to be killing on stage tonight. When you see me on stage tonight, I'm going to do it. I ain't phony.
We got you.
Thank you, sweetie.
Right, you're awesome. You.
Bye, baby. Later.
Hottest moves in the country here on Tuesday. I don't take none of this shit for granted, man. My name is Rob Stapleton. I'm ready to celebrate life tonight. You ready to do this thing? You say, hell yeah. Say, hell yeah. Well, let's do the damn thing. Coming to the stage right now is my motherfucking man. Funny as shit. Go check him out with his special on Showtime. You've seen him on BET Comic View. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, my man, Mr. Davian Velez. Yeah, I don't speak Spanish. I don't know what. You know how embarrassing this is? I failed Spanish in high school. I went to St. Raymond's Summer School in the Bronx for Spanish. I'm Puerto Rican. Everybody cheated for me the first test. Everybody fails. They're like, yo, son, what happened? I'm like, obviously, I don't know this shit, dick, if I'm here. Why are you cheating for me? Because my mom never spoke Spanish to me in the house. First time my mother ever spoke Spanish to me was at the parent-teachers conference. In high school, when the Spanish teacher tell her, I'm failing Spanish. She looked at me and said, ¿Tú no sabes español? I said, bitch, don't show me now because I'm fucking teaching you, okay? You don't reason, lady, yo. But I love reggaeton, I love salsa. How many people like reggaeton, salsa, make some noise, clap. You don't gotta be Latino. You can fake the funk like me. Seriously, sir, look at me. Oh yeah, mira, pendejo, come here, look. You, do you speak Spanish? I don't speak Spanish either. But you like reggaeton? I don't give a fuck what she does. I'm asking you, okay. You like reggaeton, right? So you know what you do? You fake the funk like me when you go to the club. What we gotta do is know the chorus line, then say eh, e, oh. At the end of every other fucking line, sound like you know what you're saying to your girl and all your tupus. You don't believe me? Play that shit again. DJ, play that shit again for me. For me. Yeah. And you gotta do this thing. Mira, go ahead. Just say that another one. She was like amazed. Oh my God, he does know everything. PX, make some noise, yo. Y'all are awesome. I'm home. I'm from Parkway, Bronx, all my life. You know, and my mom, I love her. She just turned 69, just retired. Give my mother a round of applause. She's my best friend in the world. I love her to death. She's an absolute diva. We got any divas in the house? Divas, make some noise. All right. In Spanish, it's como mierda, okay? And this is what makes my mother a diva. This is what makes her a diva. She worked at Einstein Hospital in the Bronx. She's from Pamplona. But she won't take public transportation 6 blocks to the fucking hospital. She won't do it unless it's the express bus. That's it, right? So she'll drive to work every fucking day 6 blocks. But she can't find parking. End up parking 15 fucking blocks after the hospital. That's not the diva part. Every day, my dad would pick her up at work to take her to a car so she can drive the fuck back home. I'm like, what kind of lazy going in that shit? Now she retired. I'm like, Dad, you happy? You don't gotta pick mom? He's like, no, the bitches home every day. I can't take it. They're so cute. They just made 45 years married. Give my parents a round of applause. 45 years. They're awesome. So any married couples here? Married couples? How long y'all married? How long you married? 30 years? Give her a round of applause. 30 years. You know how you make it 45 like my parents? Watch TV, even if it's the same show, in separate fucking rooms. My dad would be in the living room, should be in the bedroom. He'd be like, Gladys, put on channel 2, CSI Drive. Commercial comes, she'll come running to the living room. Oh my God, you see what happened? I can't believe he killed him. Okay, I'm like, Dad, why don't you watch the fucking show with mom? He's like, no, she don't shut the fuck up, I can't watch it. Ah, she's awesome though. Now she's home during the day and she likes to watch judge shows. Like Judge Judy, Judge. How many people do you like judge shows? Make some noise. Clap me like judge shows. Alright? You see how I identified all the people without jobs real quick or one question? Get to work. Why are you home watching judge shows? But watching them, I watched them with her during the day and it made me think about a social issue. And I never talk about social issues in my app. And the social issue made me think about, that I'm actually very happy about, is that the gay community can finally get married. Give them a round of applause. All right, clap. Seriously, that is awesome. Okay, they want to be married, they deserve it. They want to be as miserable as the rest of married America. They deserve it. But that's not why I'm happy. You know why I'm happy? Because I can't wait for the first season of Gay Divorce Court, because that shit's going to be hilarious. Think about it, Gay Divorce Court, yo? That's not during the day. That's when a celebrity judge must see TV late at night. You be watching Channel 4 and be like, tonight, after American Ninja, make sure you stick around for RuPaul's Gay Divorce Court, where justice is fierce, you know what I mean? That shit would be awesome, yo, but it's gotta be legit. It's gotta be a real court. You know what I mean? Like, they got the rainbow flag, that's a New York State American flag, you know? They got the uncomfortable wood benches, but now they got Gucci seating and the comfy. You know, they got two couples breaking up, right? They got a male couple breaking up, female couple breaking up. Male couple, two gay thugs. Yo, Your Honor, I can't take it no more, yo. He don't hold my hand no more, he don't keep it real, yo. I tell him, change the tight, he's like, call your blade. Like, stop being a bitch, you want something like that? What the fuck? That's weird. Female couple bringing up, one female, gorgeous, long black hair, big boobs, nice ass. The other female, looks like me. Same outfit, haircut, the whole shit. Not only is she suing for a divorce, she want a DNA test because she think the kids are hostile, they look a little like her. Your Honor, I want a DNA test. Woman, you don't have sperm, okay? You don't need that. But then you got two court officers, right? Court officers gotta be legit. Real court officers. You got Mike and Brenda. But now Brenda goes by Brandon. And Mike is now Michelle Estravaganza, you know? He gotta announce everybody, be quiet, they're gonna start the court. He's like, everybody shut up. Court gonna start, everybody be quiet, court gonna start. He's trying to get all technical. Hear ye. I said, everybody shut the fuck up, because RuPaul's Gay Divorce Court is now in session. With justice is fierce. That should be fucking hilarious. But I just turned 40 years old. Give me a round of applause. I just turned 40. Thank you. I just dyed the hair also too. Cause I feel like the old guy in the club. I got all grades. I went to the club the other day. I'm like, you wanna dance? She's like, no, thank you, sir. Sir. Go fuck yourself in there, huh? Okay. But I had to, but nobody told me when you turn 40, you gonna feel 40. I wake up in the morning and I gotta cough. I gotta hold the wall because my lower back be hurting for the first 2 hours. But I get injured doing anything. I got injured 40. You never worked out, you get injured. I got injured jerking off. You know how embarrassing that shit is? Like, I pull a muscle, put me a muscle. You know how embarrassing? I called that Charlie Horse. You know that Charlie Horse right here? You're just talking about it. It's fucking hurting right now. I was like, I didn't look at Pornhub 5 months. I swear to God. I was scared. But doing comedy, my favorite part is now full-time, I get to travel. I just did my first cruise. How many people here been on a cruise before? Make some noise, you've been on a cruise. Alright? Okay, I'm not talking about the Circle Line, okay? I'm not talking about the ferry. I'm not talking about the shit you were all white, you left the FDR on 23rd Street. You come back 4 hours later, just because it's cruise on a flyer, it's not a real cruise. I went on Norwegian. Anybody here been on a Norwegian cruise line before? Y'all, off the hook. They call me up, they're like, Damien, we think you're hilarious. We want you to work our cruise. It's a 7-day cruise from New York to the Bahamas. You get free amenities, free jet skis, free liquor. I can bring somebody. And as they tell me all this shit I get for free, all I kept thinking in my head was, how the fuck am I gonna sneak a weed on this fucking bus? Give it up for me, I snuck 3 8s of kush on a Norwegian cruise line for that shit. Yo, I had 7 joints per day, yo. I was popping with the weed, that was me. I tell you how I did it. I had this shit in a Ziploc bag, right? Rolled up the Ziploc bag, took toilet paper, wrapped it around the Ziploc bag. Febreze the toilet paper. Febreze it, very important. Then I took a Magnum Carta, because that's what I use, I'm huge. And I put it right over here. And then I took my baseball shorts. You know the baseball shorts does? Got the pocket right where the cup go? Put it right there, like a big Puerto Rican Jamaican dick. I'm like, throw my DSA. That's me right there. My nigga, no presence, man. Hey, get the bucket, big dick bastard. I was like, thank you. First 4 days, chilling, smoking, having a blast. But then our first stop was Cocoa Beach, Florida. Anybody here been out to Cocoa Beach, Florida before? You been there? Fuck Cocoa Beach, though. Not even Cocoa Beach. It's the worst beach in America. I almost died in this little shitty fucking beach. They call Cocoa Beach, Florida. I'm gonna tell you what happened. I take my cousin G on a trip. We go to the beach, we go on the water. She go on the water further. I go on the water up to my belly button because I had to pee. Fellas, you know we gotta pee the water. What do, sir? We go right up to our belly button and then we stop and we turn around and we're looking at the scenery. Oh, look how nice. Oh, the boat's right there. Oh, yeah, because when you turn, the current takes the piss around you, right? And it don't get out of your shit. Found my spot, ready to go. Little poop came out, tiny poop came out. As little poop came out, 5 people at the shore start screaming, shark, shark! Swear to God, 2 tiger sharks, 5 feet long, swam right by me. I'm a bitch when I see a jellyfish at Jones. Or a piece of seaweed touch me at Jones on beach, like, what the fuck is that? But a shark, yo, I froze, stopped, my dick went right back inside my body, because I'm already circumcised, I didn't want to do it again, you know? And I'm frozen right there. I'm like, yo, Gina, what they say? She's like, they said shock. I ran the fuck out that water. I did a 42. She's like, wait for me. I said, bitch, you on your own. I'm out. I'm Puerto Rican. I got 5,000 cousins. I could lose one. It's okay. I'm going to call my aunt. Like, mira, titi. Something happened to Gina. What happened? Shark attack. What'd you do? I ran, titi. Okay, I understand. Then we get to the show, she got the fucking nerves. She's like, yo, that's messed up. Why didn't you wait for me? Wait for you? Bitch, I don't speak shark. Fuck you wanna tell me? Jones, leave her alone. She got diabetes. No sugar added. You ain't gonna like the taste. I was scared myself. I wanna kept pee. They wouldn't smell your dome. Be like, oh, he's spicy. Get him. Fuck you. I'm not rich. But my favorite part about the cruise, was the freaking last day, Norwegian's gangster. They take you to their own private island. And the island is just for you, the guests. And they got everything on this island. Big water slide, snorkeling, jet skis. But everything was closed because it was raining and thundering. Thank God I have weed. Because I'm smoking under this tree looking at this water slide and they shut the fuck off. And I'm like, shh, they shut it off. But it's raining, so water going down the slide, so technically it worked. I'm from the Bronx. I don't want to fuck. I'm coming back here. I'm sneaking on this fucking slide. I stuck on that shit 10 times like a happy little fat boy. When I got one time, I need to pull the thanga out. It was like a little wedgie thanga. I said, fuck it. 10 times, security come running, blowing the whistle. Oh, what are you doing? You can't go on the slide. We got no insurance. We can lock you up. We can put put you in jail on the ball. I got scared. I looked at him and I was like, "You tell me I didn't go in the white with crowns. Sir, I was born in Winston. I can't even win to I'm dead. I can't even win to fuck you, asshole. Fuck you, asshole. You're in my feeling. You're in my feeling." Say, "Sir, I'm sorry. I didn't know you were deaf." "Okay, you know down slide. I can't get in that. I can't get in that. Thank you. And I walked away. It worked, but the problem was I kept seeing the same fucking security guard all 7 days while I'm on the boat. I walk in the hallway, he right there, I'm like, "Hello, how are you? How you doing today?" "It's wavy." "I'm David Velez. You guys have been on the hook. Keep supporting my boy, Rob. Stay with him. Three.
I got the city, you love me. They throw shots at the roof to the top. It's not in the town, you love me. But you niggas never gonna fuck with me. Just saying my name is a love me. I took them all, but they still can't catch up with me. I don't want none of these women. I feel like only this relevant. This is for me.
Give it one more time, Mr. David Velez. Yeah.